Hello everyone, you're watching Launchpad by Twitch at NGDC 2017. I'm your host Ryzy. With me is my co-host Dinu.
Hey guys.
And we have with us from Darkson Tech Nullin, who has brought us Blockstar Street Fight Madness. Nullin, how are you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. Alright, so a 3D fighting game for mobile. What's the concept of your game?
The concept is that there's an evil Blockstar corporation trying to take over the world. It's infected the minds of people from across the world with the Street Fight Madness virus, and they fight to sort of win and emerge as the winner of amongst all the fighters.
So the story goes on from there. It catches on up to a particular point. Like, do we experience a story while we play the game?
The story is actually implicit, and different locations, different settings, different aspects of the game lead to the story getting unraveled over time.
All right.
But we expect that the game would be a game of skill, a game which is highly responsive, a game where you know that if you are playing and it's not just a button masher, that sometimes somebody does a move and the moves are imbalanced. We try to balance the characters as much as we can, so that even if there's a character that looks like a frail little girl and she's fighting with a huge giant of a guy, we still try to give her moves and balance the game in such a way that any character can win against any other based on skill. And one of the reasons for that is because we as children played fighting games, and we saw that there are games which try to make a joke or a caricature out of characters and their personality traits and their nationality. And I remember choosing the and trying to play as an Indian character until I realized that they've made the Indian character so dumb and so foolish and so comical that it's just not playable. So we said we make a character who's African, we make a character who's Indian, we make a character who's a female, we make a bunch of characters, but let's make them realistic. Let's make it like this, that if I like the African character and I identify with it, then it's not like just because he's an African, he's going to dance in the jungle, or because somebody's an Indian, he will be a flying yogi. If he's Indian, he may as well look like me. If he's African, he may as well be just like you or me and
anybody else.
Just like anybody else. Yeah. And we try to keep the dress code realistic and contemporary. Characters wear cargo pants, they wear jeans, they wear t-shirts, they wear dresses. We try to give it locations which actually reflect locations in the world which we loved. Like, there's this huge, there used to be this huge lawn in Silicon Valley, close to the Google office, where there were these giant 15, 20 feet high statues of Android version models. So you had a robot which was shaped like a Kit Kat chocolate bar or a giant ice cream sandwich or a giant jelly bean robot. So, you know, we saw that. I got myself some photos of that when I went there, and I said, wow. And I showed this to my cousin, who also works in a software company. And he says, is that for real? Did you Photoshop it? And I said that, wow, if you actually have locations that mean something to us, like there's Gateway of India, Bombay, where there's this monument at the edge of the ocean, or there's these malls in Delhi, which are so beautiful and so picturesque, that it's almost as if they've come out of a model from some 3D modeling program, or yet other places. And like, there's this Bangalore Central Cantonment Station, which is one of the oldest railway stations in India, which you go there and you experience it and you say, wow, this is Bangalore. So we said that we'll give it locations, realistic real world locations which are 3D. There's a limit to how much of 3D you can put in a fighting game without spoiling the dynamic. There's a limit to how much 3D realism you can show. But we said that if you have an actual 3D model of a location inside which people are fighting, then they would actually implicitly during the course of the fight, if not explicitly, get to experience the place and the feel and look of the place.
Alright. So, what are different kind of characters you have, and do these characters have different moves?
Yes, we have. When we launch, we plan to launch it with 6 initial characters. Though our team has worked on detailing and setting moves and fighting characteristics for 20 plus characters. And we have worked on 18 or 20 locations, though when we launch, we launch with 6 locations and 6 characters.
All right.
So the characters we launch with, one guy will be a huge African guy called Godwin Chakwa. He has a move called the Hurricane Kick, where he jumps and he spins around and sort of he can land 6 or 7 blows during that one combo special move sort of thing.
Alright.
He has fireballs. Like people who have played certain other street fighting games know that certain characters can throw projectiles. He has one move called the chain hit, where it's like a punch, but it's like a punch which keeps repeatedly punching.
Right.
And there are ground kicks for all the characters.
Right.
There's a character called Naren, which is based somewhat on me, who has this somersault kick, who has this chain combo jump somersault kick, that once you enter that move, he'll land a series of blows. He also has something which is we call the capoeira kick. So capoeira is a martial art practiced by the natives of Brazil and Mexico, which was a way for the slaves and the blacks to pretend they are dancing in an aggressive warlike way when actually they are practicing and demonstrating that martial art. We have a character called Kang, who as per the backstory is Korean American, a second generation Korean American, who has this ground kick where he spins round and round on the ground when you crouch and use the heavy kick. The Kang character also has the chain hit similar to the African character, and he has a couple of other spinning over the head taekwondo style roundhouse kicks, because taekwondo style kicks are what you associate a lot with Korean fighters. We have a female character called Sophia, who as per the backstory, even though she has orange hair and a very pale skin, is actually an Indian albino girl.
Alright.
And she has a crouching ground kick, where which is somewhat like a drop kick that you see in professional wrestling on TV, that she leans on her hands and both her legs are off the ground as they knock the legs out from under a character. We also have more characters with more kicks, more variants and more moves, which sort of help equalize the balance of strength and fighting agility and speed between the characters. For example, this African character who I described with various special moves, one of the things is that when he is giving the heavy kick, it's like a inflexible, lumbering heavy kick that packs a lot of force, but once you've gone into that move, some other character like the agile and light female character can give the crouching heavy kick and knock his legs out from under him and land him on the ground. The Nalin or Naren character, who has this capoeira style roundhouse crouching kick, he has certain other vulnerabilities that when he goes into his crouching heavy kick, which is almost invincible for most of the other characters, he is at a very vulnerable position. Though if he manages to complete that move, he can knock down or cause a lot of damage to almost any character. So in this way, we've tried to balance the moves. And since, as I mentioned, the initial release as well as the soft launch which we might do for a limited segment of the audience before the release, we'll have just 6 characters. And so I think I've described 3 or 4 characters and their moves.
So there's a lot of variety going on over here.
All right. What are different locations?
Like how many locations are you covering in your game, like for this fighting stages, right? And what all locations are you covering?
Okay. So one of the locations which we have covered, since we as people and as a company are originally from Delhi, we have this location, the Saket Malls. So in Saket in South Delhi, there are a set of 3 malls, one of which has repeatedly won awards for being one of the best in Asia. The others are also very notable.
Yeah.
And which are almost interconnected, which we have in our game. We have Gateway of India, Bombay, which I believe is iconic and in many ways symbolic of the resilience and energy and liveliness of the people of Bombay and of India beyond Bombay. We have the Bangalore Cantonment railway station, which is like a cross between the modern Bangalore, which is labeled as the Silicon Valley of India, and the colonial Bangalore, which was like a cantonment, semi-hill station style city that was basically built and run by the British military and later the Indian military right up till the independence.
Right.
And we also have a location in Seoul in South Korea, which is Chinatown in South Korea. We chose that location because beyond showing Korea, we wanted to show East Asia to an extent. Mm-hmm. And we felt that Chinatown in Seoul, South Korea is like the very perfect blend between Korean and Chinese,
yeah,
which are two major East Asian cultures. We have Burj Al Arab in Dubai,
mm-hmm,
which is the skyscraper that's shaped like a sailing ship.
Uh-huh.
And the fight is set on a beach, and we have a few more locations apart from these.
All right. Now, there's also a multiplayer aspect to your game, right?
Yeah.
Can you play this game online? How does the matchmaking work? Can you just explain us all that?
Sure, sure, sure. So, when we were putting in the multiplayer aspect, we didn't think so much about online gameplay as we thought about the social element that multiplayer brings with it.
All right.
It's like if you and I are sitting and we are getting bored and we are waiting for somebody else, a third person to turn,
yeah,
up, we may as well play a game between the two of us.
Yeah.
I've seen kids in the college, which is my alma mater, play mini militia.
Yeah.
So I once saw that there were 7 or 8 boys and girls, they were sitting in an isolated spot in the sports field and giggling and laughing. And I said that, what are they drinking? What are they smoking? Why the hell are they so boisterously bonding with each other?
Yeah.
And I went close and they were playing a game, and that was a multiplayer mobile game they were bonding over.
Uh-huh.
And each time I see a pair of people with their heads into their mobile, I wonder if they are playing a multiplayer game. But we don't have too many two-player multiplayer games where you can play a few bouts, see who is better, and then just stop. So what we wanted to do was to create a two-player multiplayer experience. And while online is definitely on our roadmap,
mm-hmm,
we wanted to create the best possible multiplayer experience that takes us back to those childhood memories of a pair of friends or a pair of siblings or a bunch of cousins playing with a console connected to a TV,
yeah,
where both the people are playing the same game against each other. So that was our goal, and that's the kind of multiplayer experience we try to create.
All right. Now,
matchmaking. Sorry, I'm interrupting
you. Please.
But matchmaking is not an issue because at this point we have peer-to-peer multiplayer. We are in fact also working on a leaderboard system, which is not just a single-player leaderboard, but where you show how many fights you fought with each of the set of friends you played multiplayer against, how many you have won and lost. And that's almost like a social network that you click on one of the people somebody has fought with and you can see how many fights this particular person that your friend has defeated and won against has won and lost and against who.
When does this game come out and on what platforms?
Okay, so our planned launch date is December 1st.
All right.
And we plan to launch it. It's already launched on the Tizen platform.
All right.
The Samsung Tizen smartphone platform, which is fairly popular in India and in certain African and other Asian countries. It won an award for being one of the top 100 and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But on Android, one of the platforms we plan to launch on December 1st on is Android.
Mm-hmm.
And we will, after that, around that time, we will also launch an iOS. Part of our iOS launch date is dictated by when it gets approved to show up on the App Store.
Uh-huh.
Apart from that, we have worked very hard on making it gamepad enabled.
All
so
right.
that same couch multiplayer experience, yeah, I was describing can be experienced by players playing either peer-to-peer over a LAN,
yeah,
or with two gamepads connected to one laptop or one desktop computer, which is called local or couch cooperative
yeah,
multiplayer. So that version we will launch by late December, hopefully before Christmas.
All right.
On Steam.
Uh-huh.
And on the Mac also we plan to launch, but a lot of things depend on how soon we get approved on the Mac App Store. But when we come on Steam, we will have both Windows and Mac OS versions.
Yeah.
With all the features that we have in the mobile version
available
and a few more.
All right. Well, Nalit, this was great talking to you. Thank you so much for taking the time out and talking to us about Blockstock SFM. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And it's been a pleasure telling you guys.
It's been a pleasure.
Yeah.
Thank you.